Good evening. I'd like to call to order our regular scheduled council meeting for Monday, February 20th, 2017, at 7 p.m. Our first business is our opening ceremony, which consists of the national anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by a moment of silence for those service members that have given their lives while defending our country. Assisting us with the Pledge of Allegiance today is 7-year-old Isabella King, granddaughter of Councilwoman Pam King, and she attends Ibister School in Plymouth. So would everybody please stand?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I pledge to be responsible.
Thank you. Please be seated. Let's give a round of applause for Isabella for helping us. Okay, Ms. Bettis, can you take the roll, please?
Good evening. Mayor Walker.
Here.
Councilmember Squires.
Here.
Councilmember Kerwin. Councilmember Lynch. Councilmember King.
Here.
Councilmember McCarge.
Here.
Councilmember Jacobs.
Here.
Show Councilmember Kerwin and Councilmember Lynch absent and excused.
I will.
Our prayers go out to Jim Kerwin and his family. Jim is currently hospitalized after suffering a heart attack, and our prayers go out to him and his family, and we wish him a speedy recovery. Moving on to item 4, approval of the agenda as presented.
Mayor.
Councilmember Squires.
I move to approve the agenda as presented.
Support.
Support from Councilmember Jacobs. Any comments from the table, from the general public? Ms. Bettis?
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Councilmember Jacobs?
Aye.
Councilmember McCarr?
Aye.
Councilmember King?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. Motion passes 5-0. Moving on to item 5, community events. I'd like to call up Hank Cable from the Garden City Lions Club.
Thank you, Your Honor and Council. My name is Hank Cable, and I am a permanent resident of Garden City, and I'm here today to promote our 26th annual Pancake Breakfast, March 19th. March 19th, from 8 to 11:30, it's at the Moose Lodge, which I'm sure most people know is at Middle Belt and Ford Road. And As always, our special guests are the Garden City firefighters, our guest cooks, and it's a very elaborate menu: pancakes, sausage, scrambled eggs, juice, coffee, milk, and all you can eat. It's real reasonable. It's $5 for adults, $2 for kids under 12. And if anyone is interested, this is the flyer that we have out. I don't know if the camera can see it or not, but we also sell placemat ads, which most of the council, or almost all the council, by And these are all the Garden City businesses that buy ads for our breakfast. It's a great organization that I'm very proud to be a part of. Also, if anyone wants to get a placemat ad, they can see either myself or Kathy Harmon, who was our police, our fire chief, and is also a member of our organization. She's been a member of our club for a long time. But like I say, it's our 26th annual. So that's it. Any questions?
Thank you, Mr. Cable.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hope to see everybody there.
Thank you. Okay, I'd like to call up Monica Fulton, the Community Resource Director.
Thank you, Mayor. Good evening, Council. I have a few announcements today of some events going on at Maplewood. First up, this Thursday evening, Great Start Collaborative of Wayne County is going to be presenting a free workshop called Build Your Wealth. It's a workshop about budgeting and saving. That will be Thursday from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. this week at Maplewood Center. It is free, and as a bonus, if you call and register ahead of time, you will receive a free gas gift card. The number to call is 734-285-4001, extension 2. They will provide food as well and free childcare next door, so you can bring your kids and no need to pay for a babysitter. So that's a great thing. Coming up beginning March 7th, the Community Resources Department will be presenting Financial Peace University workshops again. It is a 9-week course for adults, and it is all about building your wealth and saving for the future, getting out of debt, which is very important right now. There is a fee for that, but we are able to discount it. Normally it's $100 per family, but we are able to provide it at $50 to the community, $25 for senior citizens ages 55 and up. That begins March 7th. You need to register by February 28th at the Maplewood Center. And along the same lines, we are also presenting Foundations in Personal Finance for Teenagers. That begins Tuesday, March 7th as well. And this is $30 for teens, and it is a 9-week program as well. Again, all offered at the Family Resource Center. And lastly, I just wanted to congratulate our Family Resource Center the Family Resource Center and their staff. They were recently awarded a Community Hero Award for reaching out to education at the PTA Founders Day event last Wednesday. It was a great event. I was able to be there to see Kim Mittenhahn receive the award on behalf of her and all of her staff. So congratulations to them. That's all I have. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, we'll move on to item 6, comments from state and county officials. And I don't see State Representative Jewel Jones wanted to speak, but he's not here yet, so hopefully he can speak under public comments later on in the meeting. Move on to item 7, petitions and communications. We have none tonight. Move on to item 8, our public hearing for tonight, our second public hearing for proposed projects and funding for the Community Development Block Grant Program. Anybody wishing to speak on that, please come to the podium at this time. Community Development Block Grant Program. Okay, I'll ask one more time. Anybody wishing to speak on the public hearing tonight for the Community Development Block Grant Program? Okay, seeing none, we'll close that out. Move on to item 9, our consent agenda.
Mayor.
Councilmember Squires.
I move to approve the consent agenda, items 9A, 1 through 4.
Support.
Support from Councilmember King. Could you read the mayoral appointment, please?
Okay. We're confirming the mayoral appointment of Kevin Hunt to the Planning Commission with a term to expire 3/31/20.
And Mr. Hunt's sitting in the back row, and thank you for volunteering to serve. Any other comments from the table? From the general public? Ms. Bettis.
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Councilmember Keen?
Aye.
Councilmember Jacobs?
Aye.
Councilmember McCarge?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. Motion passes 5-0. Welcome to the Planning Commission, Mr. Hunt. We look for good things from you. Okay, we'll move on to item B, our study session. Item B1, supplemental appropriation for library operating supplies.
C.
Okay. Item 2, supplemental appropriation, $8,750 for PEG fund balance to current fiscal year.
C.
Approval of the Netwick TriCaster 410 for Garden City TV.
C.
C.
Annual Community Development Block Grant, which is the subject of our public hearing tonight.
C.
Okay, moving on to C agenda. C1, supplemental appropriation for library operating supplies.
Mayor?
Councilmember McCarge?
I move to adopt the following supplemental appropriation for the library for fiscal year 2016-17, adding $2,000 in revenues and expenditures in, to the budget.
Support.
Support from Councilmember Keen. And this is pretty much to move funds to cover their purchase of library cards, I believe. Any other comments from the table, from the general public? Ms. Bettis?
Councilmember McCarge?
Aye.
Councilmember Keen?
Aye.
Councilmember Jacobs?
Aye.
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. Motion passes 5-0. Item C2?
Mayor?
Councilmember Squires?
I move to approve the following supplemental appropriation for the cable PEG fund, increasing revenues and expenditures in the amount of $8,750.
Support.
Support from Councilmember Jacobs. For the residents, this is paid for out of the PEG funds. This, that's your cable TV fees. Doesn't come out of the city funds. And this is so they can purchase some computerized production equipment that they use for making Garden City TV programs. Any other comments from the table, from the general public? Ms. Bettis?
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Councilmember Keen?
Aye.
Councilmember Jacobs?
Aye.
Councilmember McCarge?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. That was to move the funds. Now this is to purchase that piece of equipment, item C3.
Mayor?
Councilmember Keen?
Yes, I move to award contract for the purchase of Nettech TriCaster 410 in the amount of $8,750 from NPI Audio Video Solutions of Cleveland, Ohio.
Support.
Support from Councilmember Squires. Any other comments from the table, for the general public? Ms. Bettis?
Councilmember Keen?
Aye.
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Councilmember Jacobs?
Aye.
Councilmember McCarge?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. Motion passes 5-0. Item C4?
Mayor?
Councilmember Jacobs?
Move to approve the projects and corresponding funding allocations for the 2017 Community Development Block Grant application to Wayne County in the amount of $146,863, along with the proposed project statement.
Support.
Support from Councilmember McCarge. Any comments from the table, from the general public? Ms. Bettis?
Councilmember Jacobs?
Aye.
Councilmember McCarge?
Aye.
Councilmember Keen?
Aye.
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. Motion passes 5-0. Okay, moving on to item 10, public comments. This is your opportunity to come up and speak on anything that was not on the agenda. If you come up, please state your name, and there is a five-minute time limit. Mr. Jones?
Mike Jones, Donnelly Avenue in Garden City. On behalf of the Kiwanis, I'd like to invite everybody out to our annual Kiwanis Comedy Night, which will be on Sunday, March 12th at 5 o'clock at the Moose Lodge. We have three comedians, including our own Kevin Kramus. There'll be food available. I think it'll be a great time. It always has been in the past. Should be very entertaining, so we extend an invitation to all of you. If anybody is just anxious to make sure they have their tickets ahead of time, our DDA Director, Kim Dold, has them available tonight.
Thank you. Anybody else wishing to speak under public comments?
I have something.
Yes, sir.
Rob Pepper from Maplewood, Garden City. I just had one thing. Last year, I had a huge elm tree cut down in front of my property. And I don't know if the workers got any kind of, they did a great job. And I just, you know, thought that I should come out here and say, they took them 3 days to cut this thing down. It was at least 80 feet tall. And they did very minimal damage, real professional. So I think they deserve some, you know, a little bit of accolade for what they did. So that's really all I wanted to say. Thank you.
We'll pass that on. Thank you very much. Anybody else? Okay, city manager's report.
Thank you, Your Honor. Just a few items tonight. Of course, I want to pass my best wishes along to Jim Kerwin. I also want to mention that, as council is aware, on Sunday, February 12th, one of our firefighters suffered some pretty severe injuries while battling a house fire here in Garden City. He continues to recover. He was scheduled for surgery today. That day had to be changed. But he is continuing to recover. It's going to be a long fight back before he's back on the truck again. And we wish Mike Turch nothing but the best. And today we learned that the bond rating for the city of Garden City has been upgraded to an A+ rating. That's a pretty big deal. Mm-hmm. That's very significant for us. That's a strong rating. And actually, at this point, I'm just going to defer to Ms. Bettis to fill in some of the additional information on this. But we're very proud, particularly when you consider what we've been through. And as we all sit at, particularly during budget time, wondering, are we recovering? Here is a strong, strong sign that says we are recovering under the leadership that we have here. If I may, Your Honor, I'll defer to Ms. Bettis at this time.
That's fine. Ms. Bettis?
Thank you, City Manager. As the City Manager indicated, we went from an A rating to an A+ rating. And the secondary part of that is that they report that our outlook is stable. And so that's a big deal. They can say that we are in a negative forecasting for the future, but they're saying that we're looking really good and we're looking consistently good, sustainably good. And so that is a really big deal. One of the things that they indicate in the report that they send and that they publish worldwide is that and I'll read it if I may, the rating action is based on our view of the city's strengthened financial profile, which has been supported by recovery in the city's property tax base and proactive budgetary management. And the city's financial profile, represented by strong budgetary performance and a very strong budgetary flexibility, mitigates any risk from below average economic characteristics. And so what that means is we've been doing good is despite all of the challenges and that they're able to upgrade. It is very difficult to get Standard & Poor's to upgrade your rating. And so it's something that reflects well on the council and the management and all of our efforts and our citizens' support of that. I will just read you some of the highlights that will be available on our website probably within 24 hours or so. It says that we have strong budgetary performance. We have very strong budgetary flexibility. We have very strong liquidity. If something happened, if we got, for God forbid, a sinkhole or something like that, then we would be prepared in some way for that. Strong management. So we have, and the last one I'll read is a strong institutional framework. And so that's in spite of what they say is a weak economy. And so we should be very, very proud of the success that we've made over the years. And I'm happy to report that.
Thank you.
Thank you. You think anything else for us tonight since we're on you?
Sure. I would like to, speaking of the leadership, I would like to let you know that this year we elect our mayor and council. and that it, the time for people who are interested in being a candidate for those elected elected positions, they can get the filing petitions and all of the paperwork that is necessary to file in our office, in the city clerk's office. We're open Monday through Thursday, 9 o'clock to 5 o'clock. They have to be filed by 4 o'clock Tuesday, April 27th. I'm sorry, April 25th. 4 o'clock Tuesday, April 25th. If you come at 4:05 on April 25th, and you are my best friend in the entire free world, you will not be able to be a candidate for council or mayor. You have to be prompt, and you have to have all of the documentation and the adequate signatures and petitions. You can file those and get further information again from my office. And I think that's everything that I have.
Okay. Do you have anything else, Chief?
No, thank you, Your Honor.
Okay, we'll start at this end. Councilmember Jacob.
Yes, Mayor. First off, I'd like to make a motion to pass a resolution to recognize Mike Illich.
Support.
Would you like to read the resolution, please?
Sure. Whereas Michael Illich Sr., a Detroit, Michigan native and owner of the original Little Caesars Pizza that opened in Garden City, Michigan on May 8, 1959. Whereas we give pause, honor, and praise for the deep and abiding commitment of Mr. Illich for his over 57 years of business ownership. Whereas throughout his years of ownership, Mr. Illich continually used his business talents to improve and enhance his business, along with assisting in the beautification of the city of Garden City, city of Detroit, and surrounding cities. And whereas he served as the owner of the Detroit Red Wings since 1982, and then fulfilling his dream, purchased the Detroit Tigers in 1992. Whereas the city of Garden City is proud to call him one of our own. Now therefore, we the mayor and council of Garden City, on behalf of all our citizens, do hereby present this resolution of recognition for Michael Illich Sr. and extend this expression of condolence to Marion Illich and the Illich family.
Thank you. Nicely stated.
Any other comments?
Yes, couple things. Couple of nice events we've had in the last couple weeks since the last council meeting.
Well, hang on a minute, we got to vote on this. Comments on Mr. Illich?
No.
I'd like to say, if you think about it, how far he went from a little store at Cherry Hill in Benoit to a billionaire. Owns the Detroit Red Wings, Detroit Tigers, Fox Theater, just everything he did for the city of Detroit and the surrounding communities. And it all started in Garden City, and we should all be proud of that. So you never know how far a person can go starting out. Him and his wife were flipping pizzas in that little store at Cherry Hill, Illinois, and that took off from there. So I'm proud of what he's done, and our condolences go out to the Illich family. Any other comments? Ms. Bettis, can you take the vote, please?
Councilmember Jacobs?
Aye.
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Councilmember McCarge?
Aye.
Councilmember King?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. Resolution passes 5-0. Back to your comments there, Mr. Jacobs.
Okay. In the last couple of weeks, there's been a couple of nice events in the city. One, I was lucky enough to see Ms. Marion Langley's 100th birthday next door at the Towers, and it was a really, really nice event. A lot of the residents were there, cake, ice cream, really nice. She was a really nice lady. It was nice talking to her and the other residents. And also the PTA, their Founders Day was last week, and that was another really good event. And the children were the best part of the whole thing, I'll say that. Their stories that they came up and read, which was impressive to stand up in front of that many people and talk, was really good. But they were really nice, and it was really a good event. I was glad I went to that one also. Again, I'd like to wish Jim Kerwin get well soon, and good luck again, and get well soon to Mike Turch from the fire department. Hopefully everybody gets well quickly. And that's all I have, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. Councilmember Squires.
Yes, I too would like to wish get well quick to Mike and to Jim Kerwin. Okay, Angela Hospice offers blood pressure checks every fourth Wednesday of the month between 11 a.m. and 12 p.m. at our Maplewood Community Center. So if you're interested in getting your blood pressure checked, it's free. Just stop on by. And also, there's a group tour for seniors. The Detroit Institute of Arts on March 30th, and the DIA will provide transportation. There's cookies and refreshments that will be served at the Detroit Institute of Arts, but we must have an RSVP to Sheila by March 20th, and her phone number is 734-793-1870. The departure will be from Maplewood Center at 12 noon, and the return time will be 3 p.m., and it will be on March 30th. But we need reservations by March 20th. Okay? Thank you. That's it.
Councilmember King?
Actually, I just want to give my regards to Jim and Mike both and hope everything goes well for them.
Okay. That's it. Councilmember McCarrick?
The bond rating is so exciting, and I really would like to thank the department heads, the supervisors, the staff, and our city managers in the last 10 years who had the foresight and the strength to get us where we are now. Thank you very much. And of course, our thoughts and prayers are for Jim, and a speedy recovery for Mike. Sometimes we forget how dangerous some of these jobs are, so hope Mike recovers quickly. That's all.
Okay. I'd like to give condolences out to the family of Lisa Early, lifelong Garden City resident. She's only 47 years old. She passed away after a long illness, and our prayers go out to her family. Mike and Jim, we're praying for you. Speedy recovery. Now some good news. Garden City High School pom-poms took first place again in the state. This is their 11th title. And Garden City Middle School took second place in the state. So very good to our pom-pom squads, and I'm sure they're all excited, and they should be. That's all I have. No further business. This meeting is adjourned. Thank you.